Hello and welcome to our documentary. This documentary will be about COVID-19 and its vaccine. So, many people from all around the world right now are suffering from COVID-19. Family are losing their loved ones and employees are losing their jobs. This virus is quickly eradicating mankind. COVID-19 has taken the lives of 4.91 million people worldwide, and more than 242 million cases have been reported up till now. This virus mainly affects your respiratory system, but it can also affect any organ of your body. There have been variants of this virus as well, such as the Delta variant and the UK variant. But now, vaccines have been made, and people from all around the world are getting their vaccines now. How these vaccines work is that it inserts a weakened COVID-19 virus into your body that makes your white blood cells capable of fighting the real virus. So when it attacks you, you can be stronger or more capable of fighting the real virus.
Hello everyone, this is Dr. Marvi and today I'll be talking about coronavirus or COVID-19, which is a disease caused by an RNA strand virus. So basically viruses are of two types, DNA strand and RNA strand viruses. The most dangerous ones are the ones which are the RNA strand viruses. So COVID-19 or coronavirus is amongst those types of the viruses. It can be spread from person to person and it is diagnosed by a laboratory test that is done through the nasal swab. It is also known as the PCR. And nowadays COVID-19 vaccines have been authorized and one can get vaccinated in order to get protected from the coronavirus. The coronavirus is spread through the droplets of virus particles into the air. When an infected person or a person who's suffering from the virus, he or she breathes or talks or laughs or sings or coughs or sneezes. So the larger droplets, they may fall to the ground in a few seconds and they can be spread by touch or, you know, other ways. So we need to get protected from the COVID-19 virus, and in order to get protected, we need to wash our hands regularly with an antiseptic soap. We need to take showers regularly. We need to maintain our hygiene. Some of the symptoms of COVID-19 or coronavirus include cough, fever with or without chills. The person may experience shortness of breath or difficulty in breathing in severe cases. The symptoms basically they vary from one body to another body. So I'll talk about when I was suffering from COVID-19, like back a few months back. It was just me and my dad. Recently we got vaccinated with the second dose of our COVID-19 vaccine, which was Sinovac. And soon after our second dose, that was back in July, we developed some symptoms. So my father was the first one in the family who developed the symptoms, even though we were vaccinated. And he started developing high-grade fever with chills. And he had a very sore throat. He used to cough severely. Like, he couldn't sleep at night because of the cough. And then the severe symptoms were starting to develop and he was experiencing congestion or you can say runny nose. Then he developed fatigue. He felt like nausea or vomiting most of the times, and ultimately it led to shortness of breath. That was the time when we had to visit the doctor we got his COVID test done, and we were waiting for the test results. And meanwhile, and during that time, I also started developing some flu-like symptoms. So then one of my cousins, who's a doctor too, she recommended that I should go for the test too. So my father was actually diagnosed, and his test was positive. And then soon after I got my test done, I was waiting for the results, because it usually take 1 or 2 days to have the reports in hand. And I started some very different symptoms, like I could not smell, I could not taste. So basically my olfaction sense and my sense of taste was gone. It was very difficult. It was a very difficult time, because whenever I used to wear a perfume, or whenever I used to smell anything, I couldn't feel that smell. Whenever I wanted to enjoy my food, I couldn't taste the food. The taste buds were all, you know, they were gone, and it was a very difficult time for me. So when both of us, my father and me, we both were detected COVID positive, now was the time when they quarantined us, my family, my brother, my sister-in-law and my mother. So they quarantined me and my father. My father was in one room, I was in my room, and then my sister-in-law and my brother, he got quarantined in the other room, and my mother got quarantined in the living room. And so we all couldn't meet each other. So the most difficult times that I had to face in COVID positive situation was that for 14 whole days I could not attend my school. Well, I recently joined TIS, and I was very excited to meet my students, but unfortunately I could not meet them, and it was a very bad time of my life. So whenever I needed to talk to my mother or to anyone else, we used to had a video call, although we were in the next room. And then the food that was given to me, my father, was by my sister-in-law. We used to had those disposable plates and disposable cups and disposable crockery. So she just used to knock at the door, and then she used to leave the tray at the doorstep. And then I used to pick it up and had my food. So patients who are suffering with coronavirus, they are facing, or they are going through the worst phases of their life. So if you all want to get protected, if you all want to be safe from this deadly virus, I would recommend you all to wash your hands before you eat your food, after you use the bathroom or the restroom, after you wipe your nose, after you sneeze, after you cough. Don't forget to wash your hands. Wear a multi-layered cloth face mask, and always wear a mask when you are in a crowded place. Avoid touching your eyes, your nose, your mouth to prevent the spread of the virus from your hands. You should always cover your mouth when you sneeze. And also, you need to avoid close contact. That means stay at least 6 feet apart from a person. Do not hug each other. Avoid shaking hands, or avoid going to sick people or visiting sick people. Keep a sanitizer in your bag, since you guys are in school and it might be very difficult for you to go every after every period to just wash your hands. So you can always keep a hand sanitizer in your bag. And most important is, you should get enough sleep, you should eat healthy diet, you should drink plenty of liquids. These are the most important things, and I'm sure most of you can follow these precautions, because precaution is or prevention is better than cure. So, you know, you need to get yourselves vaccinated as well. Now there are vaccinations available for teenagers as well. So just try to keep yourself safe. Try to keep yourselves protected. And I wish you all the best. I just pray that no one of you gets affected with this deadly virus. May Allah Almighty protect our family, and take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.